In 132 C, Chinese polymath Jiang Heng presented the hen court with his latest invention. This large vase could tell them whenever an earthquake occurred in their kingdom, including the direction they should send air to. The court was somewhat skeptical of this new invention, but then, on a quiet afternoon, the device triggered their doubts, turned to gratitude. Today, we no longer rely on the ports of prediction of seismic waves, but earthquakes do offer unique challenges to those trying to track them.
So why are earthquakes so hard to anticipate? And how could we get better at predicting them? To answer this question, we need to know and understand some theories on how earthquake occurs. Welcome back to Thoughtctrl, and today we are going to discuss whether it's possible to predict earthquake or not.
Earth's crust is made up of several jagged slabs of rock called tectonic plates, each riding on a hot, partially molten layer of Earth's mantle. This caused the plate to spread very slowly at 1 to 20 cm per year. But these tiny movements are powerful enough to cause deep cracks in interacting plates. And in unstable zones, the intensifying pressure may trigger an earthquake. It's hard to monitor these movements, but the factor that shift into seismic waves are far more varied and diversified. Different fault lines juxtaposed different rocks, some of which are stronger and weaker depending upon the pressure. Diverse rocks also react differently to friction and high temperatures. Some partially melt and can release lubricating fluids made of superheated minerals that reduce fault line friction. But some are left dry prone to dangerous buildups of pressure, and these faults are subject to varying gravitational forces as well as the current of hot rocks that move around Earth's mantle. Because some of these forces occur at largely constant rate, that behavior of the plates is somewhat cyclical.
Today, some of our most reliable clues come from long-term forecasting related to when and where earthquakes have previously occurred. At the scale of millennia, this allows us to make prediction about when highly active faults like the San Andreas are overdue for a massive earthquake.
But due to the many variables involved, this method can only predict very loose time frames. To predict more imminent events, researchers have investigated the vibration Earth emits before an earthquake. According to research, scientists have attempted to consider many factors that they have initiated earthquake in the past. Studies were done to check the increased amounts of radon in local water sources, rising level of groundwater, changes in electromagnetic activities, and even animal behavior. Geologists have used seismometers to track and map these tiny shifts in Earth's crust.
Today, most smartphones are also capable of recording primary seismic waves. With a network of phones around the globe, scientists could potentially crowdsource a rich, detailed warning system that alerts people to the incoming dangers. Unfortunately, phones might not be able to provide this information in advance, not used to enact safety protocols, but such detail readings would still be useful for prediction tools for NASA, such as NASA's QuakeSump software, which can use a rigorous blend of geological data to identify regions at risk.
However, most recent studies suggest that the most recent signs of earthquake may be invisible to all these sensors. In 2011, when an earthquake struck the east coast of Japan, nearby researchers recorded high concentration of radioactive isotope pair, radon and thoron. As stress builds up in the right crust before the earthquake, microfractures allow these gases to escape the surface. These scientists think that if we built a vast network of radon-thoron detectors in earthquake-prone areas, it could become a promising warning system to predict earthquake.
Of course, none of these technology would not be as useful as the as simply looking deep inside the earth itself. With a deeper view, we may be able to track and predict large-scale geological changes in real time, possibly saving 10,000 lives a year caused by natural disaster. But for now, these technology can help us prepare and respond quickly to areas in need. That is all for now, guys. If you like the video, please like, comment and subscribe and hit the bell icon. And if you want to suggest anything, please suggest in the comment section below. Bye-bye, Tata, see you.
यार अलग ही वो डिस्टर्ब करने लग गए.
At the scale of millennia, we are recording primarily seismic waves. Seismic नहीं है ना. If you like the video, please like, comment and subscribe.